One of Excel's handy features is the ability to hide and unhide sheets. Do you use this feature? Just put a yes or no in the comments below. Now, hiding sheets is easy. You just click on the sheet or you select the sheets that you want to hide by holding down the control key, your right mouse click, select hide. But now, did you ever try to unhide a lot of sheets at once? Unfortunately, you can't simply hold down the control key, highlight the sheet names all at once to get them to unhide. You have to do that one by one. But there are easier ways to get this done, and I'm going to show you three. Let me show you different ways of unhiding really quickly. Number one is to create a custom view of your workbook. But you have to do that right at the beginning. So before you start hiding stuff, go to View, Custom View, and save this view that you have inside Custom Views. All you have to do is click on Add, give this view a name. I'm just going to call it All and say OK. Now, if I hide stuff, so let's just right mouse click and hide. To unhide them, I just have to go to my custom view and show that original view that automatically unhides all my sheets. Now there is one downside to this, and that's custom views don't work if you're using Excel tables. The moment you have a table in here, this is going to be grayed out. And since a lot of people do use tables, let me show you other options. Next way to unhide sheets is to use the immediate window inside the Visual Basic Editor. So this doesn't mean that you have to use a macro-enabled file. You can do this on any workbook, and it's super easy. First, bring up the Visual Basic Editor. You can do that using the shortcut key Alt-F11, or just right-mouse click on any tab here and click on View Code. That automatically brings up Visual Basic Editor. Now, don't worry about this stuff. Just activate the immediate window, go to View, click on Immediate Window. That's what we need. Here we just need to run a macro that's going to make everything visible. And that macro is a very simple one. We're going to use the for each collection loop. If you're interested to learn about this, I have a separate video on this. I'm going to add the link to it below, and I'm also going to add it to the cards. Here we're going to say for each SH in worksheets. Now, because I'm in the immediate window, this is going to run the code every time I press enter. But I'm not done with my code. I want to continue writing on the same line, but I still need to break it up. To do that, you can use the colon. That's the same as pressing enter inside the code window here. Now for the next argument, I need to set the visibility property of the sheet to true. And then let's add a colon as well. And then I just need to close the loop. And now I can press enter and everything is visible. If this is something you need often, you can just copy this code, put it in Notepad or in some editor, and then copy and paste it in the immediate window of the workbook you're working in, right? Because this runs it for the active workbook. Now, another way to do this is to save your macro inside your personal macro workbook. Now, I covered this in more detail inside my VBA course, but let me quickly show you the steps, because if this is something that you need often, it does make sense to have an icon for it here, and you can just click on it. It's going to unhide everything on the active workbook. And it doesn't matter if that active workbook is macro enabled or not, because you've saved it inside the personal macro workbook. Now, this is something that is always opened in the background. Every time you open a file in Excel, Excel just hides it from view, so you can't see it. To activate that personal macro workbook, we can just create any macro in there. Instead of storing our macro in this workbook, we're going to store it in the personal macro workbook. Just say OK, and I'm just going to do anything, right? So it doesn't matter what I do. I just want Excel to activate that, and I'm going to stop my macro here. Let's bring up Visual Basic Editor. Alt-F11, and I can see something new popped up here. If I open this, the macro I just recorded must be inside the module, so I'm going to double click on this, and I can see that macro here. But I don't need this I actually want this here. Okay, so let's create a sub for this. I'm gonna call it unhide all. Let's paste this, but let's dim sh as worksheet. Okay, so this macro is sitting inside my personal macro workbook. So what this means is if I, let's say, just open a new workbook here, I'm just gonna add a bunch of sheets and I'm gonna hide some of them. Now I wanna run that macro. Well, the easiest way is to add it to my quick access toolbar right here. Let's go to more commands. Let's bring up the macros here and I can see my macro from my personal macro workbook. I'm gonna push it over here. Let's modify it and call it unhide. And let's use this icon for it and say, okay. Now I can see it here. I'm gonna run it and it runs it for that workbook as well. Now this is gonna be available to all my workbooks. You just have to save your personal macro workbook and Excel automatically prompts you to save it once you close your Excel files. So these were the different ways you can unhide sheets in Excel. Let me know which one is your favorite in the comments below. Give a thumbs up if you like this video and consider subscribing if you like to receive updates when I put out new videos on this channel.